Welcome to Creative Bath Lab.
Today I'm doing a second tutorial on ingredients and reactions. For the first one, click the icon. I'm going to show you different reactions that single ingredients can make. But this time I'll be testing dry ingredients. Each bath bomb has 3 ounces of mix and a specific ingredient. Except this first one, it has nothing in it. The bomb is very fizzy and has so much vigor that the bubbles are unstable. Small bubbles form, but are very short-lived. I wanted to show you how different the reactions are when adding just a tiny bit of polysorbate 80. SLSA can create a very bubbly bomb if used moderately. This bomb doesn't have as much vigor and produces more foam, but less bubbles. This one produced a foam bomb. It also produces more foamy lather, but hardly any bubbles. This one doesn't really have any vigor, and it also took the longest to dissolve. This one is sodium alginate, which produces a jelly foam, and as you can see right away, it produces fairly large jelly bubbles. This one has double the amount of sodium alginate. It produces more bubbles and thicker foam. I wanted to try this combo because I read that calcium lactate enhances the jelly foam when used with sodium alginate. And while that may be the case, the bubbles and the fluffy foam take a major hit. So I will no longer be using this combination in bath bombs. This is xanthan gum, another jelly-like powder that's used as a thickener or an emulsifier. I was curious as to how it compared to sodium alginate. And while it is similar, the bubbles don't last as long. Double this ingredient and you get double the bubbles. This is guar gum, another jelly-like powder. I was pleasantly surprised because this one produced the most bubbles, and even more so because it's the cheapest, much cheaper than sodium alginate. Doubling the recipe didn't have a big impact. But then again, there were already so many bubbles, I don't see how it could produce much more. Mm-hmm. This is Nox gelatin, and it produced a very vigorous bomb. Lots of fizz, bubbles, foam, and action. It is very similar to the polysorbate 80 recipe, however, the bubbles are a bit more defined. This one is meringue powder, and it was almost identical to the last one. This is a collection of short clips so you can compare how different reactions are. And this is the experiment score sheet. This is just to demonstrate how I score the ingredients. Some of you were confused last time, so I included this segment. In order to make each bath bomb, I made 2 batches of bomb mix. Then I measured 3 ounces of prepared mix. And added color and the specific ingredient to be tested. Then I mixed and molded each one separately and dried them for 48 hours. Thanks for joining me today. Check out the description for the recipe, helpful tips, and the supply list at the bottom. I also included ounces and grams for the bath bomb recipe.